following UW360 story is made possible by the generous support of BECU. BECU, more than just money.
Yeah, what do we get done today?
We're a creative bunch up here. We do a lot of different kinds of things.
Let me see the oil side of it. Can you bring it up? Let me take a look at the oil part of it.
Meet UW Masters in Mechanical Engineering graduate Peter Janicki.
Where's the valve that you're using for getting the steam coming in?
Founder and owner of Janicki Industries.
When's it going to be right?
Their home office is in tiny Cedro Woolley, Washington. Their work from marine and aerospace is all around the world.
We work on so many new technologies. They were like, hey, I wonder if these guys can work in sanitation.
More exact, taking that sanitation and turning it into clean water.
And what I concluded is that there was only one technical solution that could work, and that was to evaporate the water.
Janicki BioEnergy developed a self-powered filtering system called an omniprocessor. That system takes raw sludge and transforms it into clean water, clean enough to drink.
You know, we have a little steam power plant, and making a steam power plant that's really efficient on this scale, that was pretty creative. We start with liquid waste. We feed it into what we call the evaporator or the dryer. And in that piece of equipment, we have hot metal surfaces that the material is in contact with, and we boil the water out of the solids.
Those solids are used as fuel to power the omniprocessor itself. Water vapors are run through more filters, removing chemical agents and aromas. Finally, the water vapors are sent through a condenser and returned to a liquid state, clean, filtered water.
The engineering was tremendous, and it took a lot of really smart people to kind of put it all together in the end.
In addition to Janicki, many of his smart people also have University of Washington roots.
I've been very closely in contact with a lot of the professors in the mechanical engineering department. They're great mentors of mine. These people really inspired me, and they have inspired a lot of people that work for me.
We're seeing really good removal lately.
The environment of innovation that Janicki fosters requires a new way of thinking.
So I have to reprogram most of the engineers that I get out of school. Innovation happens through breaking things, through frustrations, especially working on something that you don't know how to do, because that's how you innovate. And that requires really special people to do that.
Janicki BioEnergies has one omniprocessor already in operation in Dakar, with plans for a second unit in 2018.
And when you look at it, it seems overwhelmingly complex. But in reality, it's not that complicated. It's actually quite simple.
Peter Janicki is a big thinker, fostering a company of ideas that promise to impact the world.
I look at things like, you know, Edison's Menlo Park, a research and development facility that has thousands of scientists, chemists, physicists, all these people developing all this amazing technology here and then deploying it around the world. That is my vision. That is my dream.